You married a white girl?
Yeah.
You married a white woman that belonged to the Klan? You all right with me? First, let me just say I'm really happy that you're here, and I want to talk about the fathers, because if we don't understand what's going on with men and with fathers, we're not going to turn America around. Yeah. It is over for the country, because men don't know this, and most don't, but you have a major role given to you to protect your wife and your children, your community, and your country. And that role has been given to you by God. You represent Christ on earth. And see, our battle is a warfare between good and evil. It's not between blacks and whites or male and female. It's good versus evil, right versus wrong. And the man represent good from God through Christ, through man, through the woman, to the children. And when that man is removed, then there's nothing but anger and hatred that's coming into the family, because evil takes over the woman and children when that happens. And so evil understands what is going on. That's why it attacks the man. Get him out of the way, the rest is easy. And I saw this happen in the black community. I grew up on a plantation down in Alabama under the Jim Crow laws. I went to an all-black school. I remember the colors only, signs white only. I went to a movie theater once, and we had to sit in the balcony because we were not allowed to sit with white people downstairs. But being a teenager, I was okay with that because we had better view. It wasn't a problem. It really wasn't. We picked cotton and all that kind of stuff. But the thing that we had going on, and Larry talked about this earlier, black people were married. And because they were married, they loved their fathers, they loved their grandfathers, they loved their grandmothers, and they loved their mothers. That's what brought the peace onto us. And so we patterned after them. You know, whatever our parents did is what we do. And so what happened was, under Lyndon B. Johnson, they decided for whatever reason, and it may have started before that, but that's when I became aware of it, that we're going to help the black people, but you can't have a father in the home. You have to take him out. And so when they took him out, they broke the spiritual order. They took the Christ out of the home, and it's just been downhill for black Americans ever since. And so there are people who are working on the side of evil, whether they know it or not. They are representing evil. They hate the man because they hate their fathers, and they never were able to overcome it, so they hate all men. And so this battle is to destroy men. Because men are weak, we have crime through the roof, young kids are having babies, we have what we call a so-called race war happening. It's just all messed up because the man is weak. Children are changing their identity, their sexual identity, and all that kind of stuff because they don't have the love of a father. If they love their fathers, this would not be happening. And evil doesn't want you to understand that. And so when you try to stand up and do the right thing, it will knock you down because it does not want you to know this. They're passing laws to keep men back. They're keeping you away from your children. Some women who are angry can falsely accuse you and take your kids away. They can just make up a lie. It's not even fair anymore. They don't have a fair hearing to see if it's true or not. You're automatically guilty as soon as she says it. And that's because of who you are, because you represent Christ on earth. These kids don't listen to their mothers at home, because the mothers lose authority at a certain age. That's why the father needs to be there. And the mother loved the husband who loves what's right, and that authority is in him, and he's the one that disciplined the children. Or if the mother say, I'm going to tell your father when he get home. I remember my grandmother said, you know what? They call me Punchy. My grandma said, Punchy, if you don't stop it, I'm going to let your granddad know when he get home. Yeah. That's all I needed to hear. And I used to be I became a very emotional, weak man because I resented my father. My mother got married before I was born, but she tried to turn me away from him. And I resented my father, well, my mother, for trying to turn me away. And I had a yearning for my father. And whenever I would ask my mother about my father, oh, he's no good. Forget about him. He doesn't love you. But I wanted my dad, and I didn't put it there. It was in me to want my father. God put it there. I wasn't angry at my father. I didn't resent my father. I had a yearning for my dad. And that's what I knew as a kid, that I wanted him. we finally worked it out, my father and I. My mother, too, you know, talked to her, things got straight with us. And I talked to my father, and we worked it out. My father and I became father and son. And I used to wonder as a kid, what is it like to have a father? You know, what is it like to have dad at home every day, you know, to be talking to him? I now know what that feels like, because my father and I had a father and son relationship. And as a result of that, it allowed me to return to God. No man get to the Father unless he goes through the Son. And all men represent the Son. You represent the Son of God. And until you love, this is for girls too, until you love your father, whether he's good or bad, weak or strong, until you forgive him, you're never going to return to God. It's just not going to work, because of who he represents. And you're going to always have that emptiness. You're going to always have that void until you return to your earthly father. That's the thing that's missing right now. Even in the Bible, it says that there will come a day when I'm going to return the children to the fathers and the fathers to the children. And that means the adult children too. And it got so nice with my father and I that I had to, they started, my mother too, calling me to come to Indiana to help with the rest of the kids, because I was able to let it go. I forgave them. And I want to urge you guys that you got to forgive your fathers if you want to have freedom, if you want to be peaceful within, if you want to return to God who is with us. You got to forgive your earthly fathers for not connecting with you and passing that love down to you, and your mothers for turning them away from you. So this is what we've been doing, by the way, for the last 26 years, returning children to their fathers, meaning that we show them how to forgive so that they can feel peaceful and everything else start to work out. I want you to know that if you don't forgive your fathers, God is never going to forgive you. He has it set up so perfectly, as you forgive others, I will forgive you. And that's what forgiveness is all about. Even if they don't apologize for what they have done to you, because you forgive them for resenting them, God will forgive you. Even if they don't say, I'm sorry, God will forgive you and you will go free. I'm telling you. But you got to forgive. You got to start working on your own life. You got to let go of this anger, because you become like what you hate. And this thing will repeat generation after generation after generation if you don't drop it. It can start with you when you forgive your fathers and forgive your mothers. They can't help themselves. It was done to them too. And a lot of people, they go through a lot of physical pain, but the physical pain is gone, but a pain is still there. And what's still there is a separation from God. And Satan is your father. Because not one person with anger will enter into this kingdom within. Anger is not of God. Anger is not good. There is no love in anger at all. None. Now, you have that emotional mess going on, but that's not love. That's based on, if you treat me right, I'll treat you right. If you love me, that's not love. Because real love doesn't require anything from anyone else. It really doesn't. It doesn't require anything. I don't care if people don't love me. It's me loving them. And I used to be emotional, and I know what it felt like to want love. I'm not looking for love. I have all the love I need. And then some. I have the best life, because I returned to my father. And my son, I had a son out of wedlock. Same thing happened with my father, happened with me and my son. He hated me. And he came out here at the age of 18. He hated everything about me. Everything I loved, he hated it. And I understood. I said, you know what, Marvin, I'm sorry. You were right. I tried to be with you. Your mother wouldn't let it. And I know how you feel, but I did love you. And he went away. I didn't hear from him for a long time. But I understood. One day I get a call out of nowhere. He's like, Dad, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for hating you. I realize it wasn't your fault. I'm wrong. Even if you were wrong, I'm wrong for hating you. And now I can't get rid of my son. He doesn't even ask for money anymore. He used to ask for money because he thought money was love. And money is not love. So what I want to do, how many of you were raised by your fathers? Okay. And so how many of you have some anger toward your father? Why do you resent your father?
He was the most self-absorbed and broken man I've ever known.
And why do you say that?
He had nothing but hatred for himself in his heart, and it projected onto the world.
It projected onto you?
You bet.
In what way?
He was drunk. He was very quick with the hand. He was very inconsistent, and he was gone most of the time.
Do you think he wanted to be that way?
No.
And so have you done things that you wish you had not done, and yet you do them?
Innumerable.
I'm sorry?
Many.
And would you want your son to hate you for that?
No.
So why don't you forgive your father?
Okay. I'll work on that. I have no intellectual response to that.
Right. You had not thought about that before, right?
I've thought about it.
What is keeping you from forgiving your father?
Because I wanted an idealized childhood. I wanted somebody to love me. I wanted him to teach me. I wanted him to be a man. He right. wasn't any of those things.
Right. Had he been able to do that, it was like what Larry was saying about his father. His father went through tough times, so he wasn't able to do it. He wanted to. He did it the best way he could. Like, you have a family?
I do, yes.
Wife and kids?
Kids.
But no wife?
I've been married.
What happened?
Which time?
How many times have you been married?
Three.
You've been married three times?
Yeah.
And do you have kids by all three wives?
Only two.
And are your kids angry at you?
One is, one isn't.
And how old is the one that's angry at you?
43.
Amazing. And how do you feel about that?
I do the very best I can do to win him back, to tell him I love him.
And what do you do to win him back?
I try to text him regularly. That's what I try to do. I try to talk to him. I try to let him know he is loved by me.
Did you ever try to talk to your father?
Nope.
And why not?
I was too resentful when he was alive to want to work out anything.
And now your son won't talk to you?
Oh, no, he talks to me.
What does it feel like knowing that he think that you don't love him?
Say that again, please, sir.
How do you feel thinking that your son is thinking that you don't love him, that he doesn't know that you love him?
I'm pretty sure he knows I love him at this point.
Well, why
I think
is he
he's
angry
not willing
then?
To let me off the hook.
Oh, he's not?
Yeah.
So you want him to let you off?
Yeah.
You let your father off.
Okay.
Because you're getting what you deserve. You're getting what you put out.
Okay.
That makes sense?
Yeah.
Yeah, let your father off, and then God will return your son to you.
It makes sense.
Yeah. Somebody else said they didn't love their father. Who was it?
Me and my dad have had he was around when I was a kid, but he wasn't there. Because I know now that he had a really bad childhood. He didn't have a father himself. Can take a moment.
Yeah, I understand how I feel. The worst thing feeling you can have in life is a separation from your father. I don't care how much mama love you get, wife love you get, but that separation from your father, there's nothing more fulfilling than that. Really, it completes you. My father completed me. He made me whole again. And everyone who has forgiven their father, boys and girls, men and women, they feel whole again. What is missing is the love of a father. That's what that void is all about.
I've talked to him a lot before, but it's gotten better because I confronted him.
Right.
But he still hasn't forgiven his father because he died when he was nine.
Right.
And my dad lived in the ghettos of Detroit. And I know he had a horrible childhood, and he did the best he could at the time.
Right.
But he was overcoming when I was growing up all his problems he had when he was been in jail, prison.
What does it feel like not having the love of your father or to love your father?
It sucks. It damaged me first.
Yeah. Why not forgive him?
I don't know how sometimes.
You don't know how?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I understand. It's so easy. I had a young man come into my office on Friday, and I met him for the first time. His mother referred him for counseling. And he was 22 years old. It was the most, I met other people, but it was powerful. He had this desire to change. He wanted to know what was wrong. When he realized it was just resentment toward his father, he said, look, I'm gonna go and forgive him. He had talked to his father, but it was tough between them. But when he realized he needed to forgive them, him, he was ready to do it. And everybody who forgives their fathers, men or women, life begins. It really does. You can finally be happy. Yeah. Overcoming this is just like that. It doesn't take but a minute. It only takes a second to be free. Anybody else resent their fathers? Right here.
As I was young and going through my 20s, because I always felt like he basically put his own personal desires and wants before his family, and that caused basically my mom and dad's divorce. And so finally I had to come to terms with myself and just learn to basically move on from it.
It hurt now, not...
It still hurts, but I recognize those triggers. Yeah. And unfortunately, he passed away when I was 18. So going through my 20s, it was difficult because obviously you haven't developed intellectually as much through then. And so I always felt kind of lost and misguided. But through a lot of hard work and just finding myself, I was able to finally come to peace with that, basically.
Do you, so you still have that void, is like something that's missing inside?
I feel, yeah, yeah. I still feel a void of like not having that male figure to look up to in your life. I feel like I feel that pretty often.
Did you have your father?
Okay, he waited until my 18th birthday to contact me. And I was like, it just came out of nowhere. And I was like, what does he want?
And why were you acting that way?
Because he contacted me out of the blue, and I wasn't expecting it either.
Well, why not be happy that he contacted you?
I mean, I was happy, but at the same time, I had mixed feelings about it.
Well, have a talk with him about that. I understand that.
Yeah.
But have a talk with him about it. All right? Because of time, here's what I recommend for all you who hate your fathers, resent them. All you have to do is to examine yourself, know yourself, and you're going to see how out of control you are. You do the things you don't want to do, the things you would like to do, you can't do. It seems as though something else is controlling you. You know, fathers don't wake up in the morning and decide, I'm going to make a baby so I can leave it, so I can hate it. They're not doing that. They have the same identity that's made a home in them, and it comes from anger. And it causes them to do the things that they don't want to do. They leave their kids, they can't have their wife, but they still love you. And so if you could get to know yourself, and you wouldn't want your kids to feel that way about you because you know you love your kids, if you can understand you, it will cause you to forgive your fathers. You got to get to know yourself first, know thyself, and then you can see and understand, and it will help you forgive your father. It will absolutely cause you to forgive your father. So you got to get to know yourself. And then once that happened, it would be as though you never missed a day with your father. It would be like it never happened. There's no reminder, no pain, no emptiness, no void, no emotions, and it would be like you never miss your father. So you got to get to know yourself, and then it will help you. It will cause you to forgive your earthly fathers. Most people don't know themselves. They're not paying attention to what is driving them. And none of you hate your father. All of you long for your father. You don't hate your fathers. But you have been told you hate your father, and you're believing that. It's not true. One last point. Did you know that Adam, you remember Adam, this guy that God created with his hands? He never knew a mother. He never knew a mother. He only knew his father. And because he never knew a mother, he was never traumatized the way that we are. Because he was created by God, so he only had a relationship with his father, same mindset, the same everything. And so paradise was on earth. But we, by us being born through the woman, we only know the woman. We don't know the father. That's why we got to return to the Father. And we got to overcome that trauma of going through her. And because we were traumatized that way, we picked up all of her ways, all of her ideas, all of her emotions, all of her everything. We don't even think like men. because we have not returned to the Father. And your father and his father had the same problem. They were traumatized going through the woman, so they didn't have the mindset. God wanted us to have his mindset so he could live through us to love our wives, love our children, and love one another. That's why we must be born again, what they call born again, but it's a return to the Father. That's what we're yearning for. And our environment reminds us that something is wrong, and that's what's wrong. We got to overcome this trauma by returning to the Father and developing his mindset instead of our mother's mindset. That's why men think it's okay to be emotional. A man should not be acting like women. A woman is being a woman, and a man is being a man. The man is the foundation. And so if you're an emotional, weak foundation, what good are you to anyone? Your wife needs you to be strong. She needs you to love what's right with all your heart, soul, and might. And, you know, love God with all your heart, soul, and might. And then love her, but with God's love, not your phony love. All right? So examine that and think about it. All right? You got to start knowing yourself. We got to do it now because we're losing families. We're losing the country. We're losing friendships. The world needs us. And the enemy is not going to like it, and that's fine. Let them call you whatever they want. Let them attack you. You be strong. Learn to speak up, but don't resent. Speak up, but don't resent. You got to do that. And your kids, your wife would love it. Your kids would love that because it's all love all the time. Any man that needs his wife to love him is pathetic. Love comes from above, down below. And your wife going to love you because you love what's right. She can't help that. And she doesn't have it to give it to you. She receives it from you. And our kids need this, folks. And I don't have time to get into it, but there's no such thing as racism. It's about all this anger and this stuff that's going on. People are angry at each other. And the children of the lie call it racism. There's no such thing as racism. It's a warfare between good and evil. That's why we've not been able to resolve the problem, because it's a lie. And the enemies are using it against us. Oh, one last thing I want to tell you. How many of you want to start a business? Okay, how many of you that want to start a business already have a job? Okay, so you already have a business. All right? Treat your job like it's your business, because you are representing you. You're learning how to deal with people. You're learning how to keep your word. You're learning how to work hard. You're learning how to grow up and deal with issues. There's no different in that than it would be if you had your own business. And one thing will lead to another one. So you already have a business. So think that way. Think clearly so you can grow and mature. All right? Larry, thank you so much, man. It meant a lot to have you here.